teams participating in the FIM Enel Motor E-World Cup in 2019, and our first look at the latest spec Energica Ego Corsa motorcycle as well. So we'll just run through, to bring you up to speed, the latest news involving the Enel Motor E World Cup. We've got confirmed two rider teams are as follows: Tech 3 Racing, the LCR team, Pramac Racing, the Angel Nieto team, Esponsorama Racing, which is basically Reale Avincia Ducati, Rossini Racing. They are all running confirmed two rider efforts in the championship next year. One rider efforts will be run by the following: the Sepang International Circuit team. They're going to be very, very busy next year. You can see Johan Stigefelt, one of the various team members here, gathered for this special photo opportunity here in Misano. Of course, they've got teams next year in Moto3, Moto2, and the MotoGP World Championship. Other confirmed teams running one riders next year: Mark VDS Racing. You can see Mark van der Straten as part of this team opportunity as well. The Pons Racing team, IO Motorsport, Dynabolt Intact GP, of course, who are running Marcel Schrotter, who's on the front row of the grid for tomorrow's Moto2 race, and the SICK 58 Squadra Corsa team. So there are going to be 18 riders competing in the inaugural championship next year, as we say, on the new Energica Ego Corsa machine. Just to bring you also further information about the format next year for the FIM Enel Moto E World Cup, there's going to be five races. We've actually got some exclusive breaking news coming for you very, very shortly. There's going to be two free practice sessions throughout the weekend, followed by a qualifying session. The races will be run on Sundays over a maximum of 15 minutes. They will take place before the Moto3 race. And I think now is the perfect time to bring in a man who's actually got experience of riding this Energica Ego Corsa machine. My co-commentator, my partner in crime, Simon Crafer, one of many riders who's actually been fortunate enough this year to have a go, have a spin out on one of those Energica Ego Corsa machines. Simon, you were lucky enough to ride this new motorcycle in Qatar, the only round of the championship.
Yep.
Zero Emission Motorsport coming to the Grand Prix World Championship next year. Very exciting times, innovative technology. You had a chance to ride the bike in Doha. What were your first impressions? I think you were quite impressed.
The big thing I was impressed was throttle connection. You know, I had no idea what to expect when I got on it, you know, apart from very little noise, a lot of wind noise, which you don't normally notice with motorcycles because of their engine noise. You can just hear this whistle and wind noise. But honestly, the thing I was impressed with was the throttle connection and acceleration. It goes something like 600, you know, that would be my estimate. And, but I rode the standard road bike, and like any standard road bike on the track, the brakes and suspension aren't good enough, you know. This bike you can see here now, I've been out on track doing the GoPro lap, hammering around on a BMW 1000 when Caparossi is out testing and developing it. And it's something else because they've got big brakes on there, they've sorted out the suspension, and he is really riding it. Like I said, down the straight at similar speed, 600, which is Moto 2 speed, it's quite as quick around the corners because of that extra weight. But with guys like Caparossi and other XGP guys riding it next year, which there's a bunch of big names talking about coming and doing it, on what they've developed there, it's going to be well worth watching.
Yeah, Simon, when you look at some of the teams that are involved, some of the biggest teams in the MotoGP World Championship, you know, the likes of Tech 3 Racing and the LCR team, Pramac Racing, they've had a great day today with Jack Miller on the front row. 18 bikes on the grid next year. What do you expect from it? It's an exciting prospect, isn't it?
Well, like I just mentioned, to me, with the speed of the bike that it is now, that I've seen how Caparossi can ride it around, I'm talking, we were hammering around on standard thousands, and he was doing the same sort of speed, you know, as me riding hard on a stock thousand. So it's been developed a lot since the bike that I've been, you know, got to ride on the demo lap. I think the other big draw for most people will be, and me as well, is to see old heroes, like ex-heroes, backing it up on these, you know. You were, like, for example, and the current one, as even Braden Smith's talking about, that guys like Whispers of Depunier and a few others, I think that's going to be worth watching.
Always great to hear your feedback here, Simon. Thank you very much indeed. If you're interested in finding out who will do the demonstration lap here on the Energica Ego Corsa tomorrow, it will be 1982 500cc World Champion, a hero in these parts, of course, Franco Uncini. Now, it's my pleasure to welcome next a very special guest, a man who's played a fundamental part in the running of the FIM Enel Moto E World Cup. It is Executive Director Nicolas Gouvet. Nicolas, always a pleasure to see you. Just before we speak to Nick, I just want to run you through some key dates, because this man is about to give us some exciting and exclusive news. Dates for your diary. There are three official tests later on this year, all taking place in Jerez from November the 23rd to the 25th. Dates for your diary in 2019. Another official test, March 13th to the 15th in Jerez. And the final pre-season test, also taking place at the Andalusia circuit, will be from April the 23rd to April the 25th. Now, we know that next year's championship is exciting. Inaugural FIM Enel Motorway World Cup will take place over five rounds. I'm delighted to say, exclusively now, Nicolas Goubert will tell us exactly where those races are going to take place. Over to you, Nicolas.
Yeah, with pleasure. So the first one will be Jerez, which is the start of the real championship, I mean, in Europe. Then we'll follow up, we'll be following up with Le Mans. Then we'll go to Germany, Sachsenring. Then Austria. And then the last round will be here in Misano.
And just for your key dates for your diary there, of course, if you've been following MotoGP this week, which I'm sure you have, the provisional 2019 calendar was released. As Nicolas said there, Jerez, May the 5th, Le Mans, May the 19th, the Sachsenring, July the 7th, the Red Bull Ring in Austria on August 11th, and back here in 1 year's time, Misano, on September the 15th. Nicolas, there's so much interest in zero-emission motorsport right now. I know you're working so closely with all the technical partners, working on the Energy Eco course and machine. In terms of performance, what can the fans watching next week, what can they expect from the bike?
The bike, you know, it's pretty fast. The maximum speed is up to 270 kilometers per hour in the qualifying mode, so which is quite fast. And the lap time will be somehow close to the lap time.
And just finally, Nicolas, there's obviously always so much anticipation and excitement about the riders. We know there are 18.
To race in the MotoE, and now that we've done it, I think that very shortly, you know, we'll start hearing names and confirmation of names. So by the next race, I think we know a few, and that will be many of them. And
he's expressed a lot of interest in racing one of these Energy Grego course machines next season. I mean, that would be a great boost for the championship, wouldn't it, to have a current top-level MotoGP rider on board?
Yeah, that would be absolutely great, and I do hope it will happen. And I know that Bradley, you know, he likes technology. He's, as you said, I mean, a great MotoGP rider. So, and I'm sure he will not be the only one, having been on MotoGP before.
Well, always a pleasure, Nicolas, to talk to you. It's been fascinating to see the project develop over the last few months, and we can't wait to see the inaugural FIM Enel Motorway World Cup next season. We wish you well over the next few months as plans continue for that inaugural championship. In the meantime, we'll say goodbye to you from the Misano World Circuit, Marco Simoncelli. Don't forget to tune in tomorrow for what promises to be a breathtaking MotoGP race. If anything is to go by from qualifying today, we are in for a sensational 27-lap race. Jorge Lorenzo in Ducati's home race, starting from pole position with Jack Miller and Maverick Vinales on the front row of the grid. And who can write? You can never write off Marc Marquez. He starts from fifth. And the home crowd hero, Valentino Rossi, going from seventh place. We'll say goodbye from the Misano World Circuit, Marco Simoncelli. Enjoy all the race action tomorrow.
Right.
Anytime,
thank you so much.
Anytime you need anything.
Thank you. Really appreciate it. Thank you very much. Thank you. No worries.